what you were seeing before you then, is one of Great Britain's greatest wastes of money. The opportunity cost of the London Olympics, which the true cost is probably something like 20 billion, is a choice. A choice between enriching a few thousand people and stealing from the nation. If somebody gave me 20 billion and said, put this to good use for this country, what I would do is build thousands of youth centres across the country. I would staff them with good quality staff, resource them well, and completely solve this problem of disenfranchised youth in this country. The government's made a choice. The people in power have made a choice. They've said what their priorities there are. Their priorities are making us pay for the Olympic family to stay in five-star hotel bedrooms in West London, mostly in an area called Park Lane, which they will leave in their chauffeur-driven BMWs, provided by Greenest Olympics ever sponsor BMW. They'll be transported along VIP lanes that we, the ordinary Londoners, aren't allowed to go in. We get fined £200 if we do. These people will be transported from their hotel bedrooms along these VIP lanes to venues, to the best seats in venues we paid to build. It's disgusting. If you look at the security fence, that really says everything. The top of it has 5,000 volt electric cables on. This isn't an inclusive event. This is exclusive. So we've got the VIPs, the Olympic family, travelling from their five-star hotel bedrooms in Park Lane on the VIP lane, specially for them, that we can't go into. They go straight into their VIP enclosure within the Olympic Park. They never have to come into contact with the ordinary Londoner. And, I mean, thank goodness for them. They could catch a nasty disease.
Exactly. Well,
who knows?
The athletes are being told not to shake hands in case they do catch a nasty disease.